Okay students, today we discuss about sixth group of elements. The topic is reactivity towards to halogen. Reactivity towards to halogen. Sixth group of elements form MX6 type of halides, MX4 type of halides, MX2 type of halides, and last one M2 X2 type of halides. MX6 type of halides are called as hexahalides. 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 MX4 type of halides are called as tetrahalides. Here is dihalides. These are monohalides. Mono halides, dihalides, tetrahalides. So let us discuss one by one. First one is MX6 type of hydrates. Example is SF6. Sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur hexafluoride. The central atom undergoes sp3d2 hybridization. sp3d2 hybridization. The shape of the molecule is octahedral. The shape of the molecule is octahedral. Central atom is sulfur. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, students, it is octahedral structure. This is about hexahalide. MX4 type of halides, tetrahalides. Example is SF4, SeF4, TeF4. Sulfur tetrafluoride is a gas. It is liquid. It is solid. SeF4 is gas. SeF4 liquid. TeF4 is solid. The central atom undergoes sp3d hybridization. SF6, sp3d2. SF4, sp3d hybridization. The shape of the molecule are SF4 or SeCl2. Sorry, SeCl4. Central atom, sulfur. Example, SeCl4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and remaining one lone pair of electron. The shape of the molecule is trigonal bipyramidal with one lone pair of electrons. Trigonal bipyramidal with one lone pair or CISA. Or CISA is the most important point. Next, MX2 type of halides. Dihalides. Example, SeCl2. Central atom undergoes sp3 hybridization but has bent shape. Sulfur, Cl and Cl. It is a bent shape. Next, M2X2 type. Monohalides. Monohalides. Example, S2Cl2 and Se2Cl2. Monohalides can exist in dimer in nature. S2Cl2. S2Cl2 gives rise to SeCl4 plus S. Dihalides. Dihalides are dimeric. Monohalides can exist in dimeric state. In dimer state, they are undergoes disproportionation. Disproportionation takes place. S2Cl2 gives rise to SeCl4. 2 to the 4. 2 to the 4. 1 plus 3 sulfur. Next, Se2Cl2 undergoes disproportionation, we get CCl4 and 2 moles of Fe. Sulfur to sulfur, sulfur to sulfur. So this is about disproportionation reaction. This is about reactive towards to halogens. Next up, next topic is dioxygen. Preparation of dioxygen. Okay, dioxygen is obtained by the heating of potassium chlorate. Potassium chlorate and potassium permanganate. KClO3 gives rise to KCl plus oxygen. 2KCl, 2 and 3 moles of oxygen. Potassium chlorate gives rise to potassium chloride plus oxygen. Next, potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate gives rise to potassium manganate plus manganese dioxide plus oxygen. Plus oxygen. Potassium permanganate on heating to give potassium manganate and manganese dioxide plus oxygen. This is the first equation. Next one, second. Dioxygen is obtained by the thermal decomposition of metal oxides. Metal oxide like silver oxide gives rise to Ag plus oxygen. Here is the 2 moles of oxygen. 2 to the 4, it is 4. Next, thermal decomposition of mercury oxide. Hg plus oxygen. Here 2 moles. Next, lead dioxide, PbO2, Pb plus oxygen. It's about dioxygen obtained from metal oxides on thermal decomposition. Next, H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is easily or readily decomposes into H2O and oxygen in the presence of manganese dioxide. This is about preparation of oxygen. Next, properties. Oxygen react with calcium gives rise to calcium oxide. So 2 moles and 2 moles of calcium. Magnesium plus oxygen gives rise to magnesium oxide. It is 2 moles and 2 moles. If you take aluminium plus oxygen gives rise to aluminium oxide, Al2O3. It is 3 moles and 2 moles. The 4 moles of aluminium. 2 to the 4, 4 aluminiums. 2 to the 6, 3 to the 6. And zinc sulfide, 2 moles, 3 moles of oxygen gives rise to 2 moles of ZnO plus 2SO. ZnS plus 3O2, 3 to the 6, 2 plus 2, 2 plus 6. 2 sulfurs. Next, CH4 plus oxygen gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. Here is the 2 moles of H2O, 2 moles of oxygen. Okay. Next, some compounds are catalytically oxidized. 2SO2 plus O2 gives rise to 2SO3 catalytical, catalytical, that is B2O5. Sulfur dioxide plus oxygen to give sulfur trioxide. Catalyst is B2O5. And HCl plus oxygen gives rise to H2O plus Cl2 in the presence of CuCl2. Cupric chloride. So oxygen to 2 moles of HCl, 2 moles of Cl. Hydrogen chloride plus oxygen gives rise to water plus Cl2 in the presence of CuCl2. All these are properties. Next, uses. Oxygen is used in respiratory system as well as combustion. Respiratory system and combustion. Respiratory system and combustion. Next one is, it is used in oxyacetylene welding. Oxyacetylene welding in metals. Next, it is used, oxygen is widely used in hospitals. Widely used in hospitals. Next, oxygen is used in at higher altitudes for flyers and mountaineers. Flyers are mountaineers. So this is about preparation of oxygen and properties and uses. Next one is some important oxides. First one is acetic oxide. Acidic oxide. An oxide which gives acid. An oxide which gives acid on hydrolysis. Such type of oxides are called as acidic oxides. Generally, non-metal oxides gives acids. Non-metal oxides gives acids on hydrolysis. Example, SO2. SO2 plus H2O gives rise to H2SO4. That is sulfurous acid. One more example for you, SO3 plus water gives rise to sulfuric acid. H2SO4. And nitrogen trioxide, that is dry nitrogen trioxide, undergoes hydrolysis gives rise to HNO. This 2 moles of HNO. Nitrous acid. N2O5 plus water gives rise to HNO3. That is nitric acid. Next, P4O6, phosphorus trioxide plus water gives rise to H3PO3, phosphorus acid, 4 moles of 6 moles. Okay students, trioxide, phosphorus trioxide undergoes hydrolysis gives rise to phosphorus acid. Next, P4O10 plus H2O gives rise to H3PO4, 4 moles of phosphorus. 4 threes are 12, 6 moles of water. SO2 gives what? Sulfurous acid. It is weak acid. Hey, generally, lower oxidation state of sulfur, it is minus 6, it is plus 2. Minus 6 plus how much? Minus 4. Sulfur exhibit plus 4. Here minus 8 plus 2. Minus 8 plus how much? Minus 6. So that is plus 6. Here is sulfur exhibit plus 4 oxidation state. Here sulfur exhibit plus 6 oxidation state. Lower oxidation state of sulfur, us. Higher oxidation state of sulfur, ick. In the similar way, nitrous acid, nitric acid, phosphorus acid, phosphoric acid. Okay, students, this is about acidic oxides. Next, what? Next is basic oxides. Basic oxides. Generally, metal oxides gives basic nature on hydrolysis. Basic oxides. An oxide which gives base on hydrolysis. Generally, metal oxides gives base with the water. Examples: sodium oxide for the Na2O plus water gives rise to sodium hydroxide. How many moles? 2 moles of sodium hydroxide. Okay, students, Na2O plus H2O gives rise to NaOH. Na2O but not NaO. According to criss-cross formula, we get Na2O, that is sodium oxide. Next, magnesium oxide, MgO plus water, gives rise to magnesium hydroxide, MgOH taken twice. Next, calcium oxide plus water, gives rise to calcium hydroxide, COH taken twice. Barium oxide plus water gives rise to barium hydroxide. Okay, students, this is about basic oxides. Next one is amphoteric oxides. Some oxides can exhibit acidic and basic nature. I can simply say that some oxides react with the acid as well as base. Examples are Al2O3, Sb2O3, SnO, SnO2, PbO, PbO2, and zinc oxide, BuO. So all these are some important amphoteric oxides. For example, aluminium oxide, Al2O3, act as an amphoteric oxide. An oxide which reacts with acid as well as base. Example, aluminium oxide reacts with acid. 6 moles of HCl, 9 moles of water gives rise to AlH2O taken 6 plus 3 plus 6 moles of Cl minus, that is aqueous. Next, Al2O3 plus 6 moles of sodium hydroxide plus 3 moles of water gives rise to 2Na3AlOH taken 6. Okay, students, Al2O3 react with HCl, Al2O3 react with sodium hydroxide. Such type of oxides are called as amphoteric oxides. Last one, that is neutral oxide. These are some oxides which are neither acid nor base. Example, carbon monoxide, N2O and NO. Carbon monoxide, N2O, nitrogen first oxide. Next one is nitrogen second oxide, nitrous oxide, nitric oxide. So this is about oxides.